called In the Arms of Destiny. She shone like a jewel in the midnight sun. Her warmth and her loveliness were beyond all compare. In a time of lost legends so far in the past, when the new dawn order held back the despair, knights and ladies so pure of heart endeavored together to make a new start, to uphold the sacred under God's good domain, adorned in white and blue, Lady Destiny, her name. Quiet and gentle, noble and sublime, she offered no offense to eyes or to ears, but offered only her love and support to the Lord. Her sweet voice rang like music of the spheres. His name, Sir Triskin of the fair turquoise lawns, he was a young knight of that order, they say. He believed in all that was good and true. He knelt each night in his armor to pray. The two were close and of the same age, and although there were feelings, they could never be more, for each in their own way upheld chivalry's code, and friends as such will always endure the trials and travails of this dark land, born of equality from the stars, born of a love so noble and grand, and blessed by a truth that is greater by far than the petty treaties of this earth, the false possessions or the greed of dearth. Her colors he would have been honored to wear in battle, in quest, or for that matter, anywhere. But this likewise was never meant to be, and both bore this fate with grave dignity, for each served a purpose higher than themselves, and the new dawn order shone as the new epoch arose. Each lady and knight could almost but grasp the unparalleled holy age to come, when all that would rain down from above would be joined to all that was once below. 25 years, they came and they went. The dreams of the order were long gone and spent. The knights and ladies had been vanquished with ease, driven to despair, forced to their knees by the powers that hold this earth in their grasp. Coarse and perverse, they sting like the asp. So Triskin now stands upon this shore all alone, haunted by memories, he's chilled to the bone. Among the runes he clings to so tight, whilst the world of man offers little but blight. His memory of destiny is as if but a dream, among the crude, so unreal it does seem. And the spirit of the new dawn age, it fades, neath the blinding loss and fear that pervades. But still he adheres to the code of chivalry, in the land of the lost, in his village by the sea. So now in the mist, he hears a peer's cry, "Sir Triskin, please help me," cried a damsel by and by. He knew that sweet voice without any pause. 'Twas Lady Destiny reigniting his cause. He whirled around to view her, accosted as such by a vile, vicious knave so loathsome as much. Refuse piled high upon a foul bench, his very bearing it bore such a stench. Sir Triskin arose much like in days of old, his strength and his honor refurbished so bold. He raised his arms to the sky, and with powerful voice he cried, "Unhand her, fiend, or perish by choice." He wore no more armor but that of his pride, his only accoutrement, his valor inside. The knave dropped Destiny onto the cold ground and fired his charge at the source of the sound. Triskin sneered at his wound as if but a scratch. He leapt at the knave before he could catch his breath from the weapon that he had just shot. The dark, lonely years now Sir Triskin forgot. He fought with the might of at least 20 men in defense of the honor and safety of his friend. Within a short but fierce time, the battle was done. The miscreant vanquished. Sir Triskin had won. He raised his dear friend back up to her feet and kissed her small hand so soft and so sweet. "Lady Destiny," he said, "it does my heart good you are well." Then blood poured from his wound and to the pavement he fell. Destiny held his head in her arms. She stroked his damp hair to protect him from harm. "Sir Triskin, my dearest, you have restored my broken heart." He held her so tight now, not wanting to part. The tale of Sir Triskin is now said and done. A knight of the quest, his battle was won. And for all who may ponder, his spirit is free. He died for love in the arms of destiny. Thank you. Thank you so much.